continuing part is second one, physiographic division of India. That is the Northern Great Plain. In the previous class, we discussed about the Northern Mountains. The Northern Mountains or Himalayan Mountains that we discussed in the previous class. Today, I will continue the second one of physiographic division of India. That is the Northern Great Plain. This Northern Great Plains lies between Northern Mountain and Peninsular Plateau. You can see in this map, this is the place, this much land is covered with the Northern Great Plain. The north of it is below of Himalayan Mountain, and it is located in north part of Peninsular Plateau. North Plateau lies between Himalayan Mountain and Peninsular Plateau of India. This much part is covered with the what? The Northern Great Plains. Northern Great Plains. Here, how it is formed? It is formed by the depositional work of three rivers. Which are the three rivers? Sutlej, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These rivers are flowing here. The birthplace is Himalaya. The river Ganga flowing here and joined the Bay of Bengal. Brahmaputra also. Birthplace is in Himalaya and passes here, joined the Bay of Bengal. And the Sutlej river also flowing here. These three rivers are perennial rivers. What is meant by perennial river? Perennial rivers means the water is filled with water throughout the year. Water rivers are filled with the water. Why? Because some rivers are not perennial. Non-perennial rivers are there. That during summer season, some of the rivers are dried up. Therefore, those rivers are not called perennial rivers. Perennial rivers means throughout the year, the rivers are filled with the water. These are not rivers which are flowing in greater northern great plains are perennial rivers. Throughout the year, water is filled with these rivers. These are formed by the depositional work of. Deposition means what rivers are flowing here. When it flows, it carries some of depositional of waste materials. Soils are carried through when the rivers flowing, and it created a separate land, flat land. And the alluvial soil is found in this great plain. That is fertile soil, and water facilities are there. Therefore, these great plains are very important to grow agricultural purpose. It is very helpful to Indians. Most of the paddy, wheat are growing in these places, Northern Great Plain. Why? Because this land is fertile soil, and rivers are there. So irrigation is also, it helps us to irrigation or supplying water to agricultural land. So this helps to improving Indian agriculture. You know that India is, most of the people are depend on agriculture, and Indian economy is also depend on agricultural production. Therefore, this land is very important for India for economic purpose. Then how much land is covered with this Northern Great Plain? 7 lakh kilometers square. It covers 7 lakh kilometers square land is covered with this Great Plain. It's the flat land, and the fertile soil is there. Water facility is there. It is very important for agricultural purpose. Understand this much? Hope all of you are understand this much. Then what are the importance of Northern Great Plain? And now I tell you what, the land is very fertile, and what rivers are, many rivers are flowing here. These rivers are perennial rivers. throughout the year, these rivers are filled with water. That helps to improving Indian agriculture. Irrigation facilities there. What you know that what is meant by irrigation? Irrigation means supplying water to the agricultural land from rivers or ponds or any source. So irrigation facilities there. That helps to improving agricultural production. And because water is there, rivers are there, and flat land and alluvial soil is there, fertile soil is there. That helps to yield more. Helps to improve the production. Then a road facility, railway facilities are there, communication facilities there. That helps to communication facilities there, road facilities there, railway facilities there. That helps to improve industries and urbanization. This flat land, it helps to improve the industries. Industries need road facility, railway facility, and agricultural production. Some of the industries are agro-based industry. That means the raw materials for industries are depend on agricultural production. For example, a cotton industry, raw cotton is the raw material for a cotton industry. Sugar industry, sugar cane is the raw material of a sugar industry. So agricultural production are raw material to the industries. So this agricultural land that improves industries. And urbanization, cities are also improved in this northern Great Plain. These are the importance of second one Indian physical division, that is northern Great Plain. Then it also pilgrim center. Many pilgrim centers are there. Pilgrim means Tirthayatra. It means many temples are also found in this northern Great Plain. So people are pilgrimage to these centers. Pilgrimage centers are there in the northern Great Plain. These are the importance of northern Great Plains. Second one, physiographic divisions of India. Understood this, all this are should know the points. How much land covered with the Great Plain, northern Great Plain is covered with the 7 lakhs kilometer square. How it is formed? The northern Great Plains are formed by depositional work of three main rivers. Which are the three rivers? Sutlej, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These rivers are flowing here in this land. And it is lies between northern Himalaya or northern mountains and peninsular plateau.